Hello and welcome back to our channel Nursery to Versity. So in this video today we are going to understand how we can install and set up the node process. As we in the previous video we have already understood how the Node.js work, what are the different npm packages, means basic meaning of npm packages, how can we use that, we will see in the next videos about that. So in this video we will set up the first foundation step of our Node.js, that is installation process. Okay, as in my laptop I am having the Ubuntu, so I am going to tell you the steps of how you can install it on the Windows also, but let us first understand how can we install the Node.js on the Ubuntu. So the steps are, as you can see on the slide, the first one is you have to go to this particular link. You can go and you can also open your terminal. We will see in the next slide how can we do with the help of the commands, how can we download the Node.js with the help of the commands. Okay, so let me get back to this site. Okay, see, this is for the Ubuntu one. Okay, so what you have to do, as you can see that we have two options. One is the current one. Okay, so you don't have to download that because they have given the latest one, but there are still some features that are not available completely. So we are going to understand the Node.js with the help of the first one. Okay, so in Ubuntu what you have to do, just click on that. Okay, I'm not going to click on that as I have already installed it. Okay, so just click on this one and download it. Okay, so the download will begin. After that what you have to do, just open that. After downloading, open that and it will show some steps. Proceed with that steps, continue, and at the end it will show you with some installation button. Just click on that install and it will get easily installed. Okay, and if you face any problem regarding installation, you can mail your queries in the mail ID, and I will provide the mail ID in the description. You can easily tell us what are the problems you are facing in downloading the Node.js in Ubuntu. Okay, now if you want to check what you can do, just go to your terminal. Okay, and let me come out of this. Okay, so just write Node.js minus minus version. Okay, so I am having a version 8.10.0. so with the help of this you can check whether your Node.js is properly installed or not. Okay, so this is the one part, how can we install manually. Now we want to do with the help of the commands, how can you do that. Okay, so just write the following commands on the terminal. These commands are shown here. I will write all these steps in ABC in the description of the video. You can directly copy and paste it in your terminal, terminal one, and you can easily install the Node.js. The first one is easy, but still if anyone faces issue, you can install it with the help of these commands. Just copy and paste all these commands and you will be able to download your Node.js in Ubuntu. Okay, now let's have a look how we can install the Node.js on Windows. For first one, what you have to do, just go to this link. I will provide this link and I can show you also. This one is a link. Okay, so in this what you have to do, just find out which one is yours, if you are a 32-bit or a 62-bit, 64-bit. So what you have to do, just click on this windowsinstaller.msi1, and if you are a 32-bit or 64-bit you can do according to that. And what you have to do, just after clicking it will get download, and then click on run button and the installation will proceed, and then click on again and again and you will reach on the finish one, and after finishing just click on that and your Node.js will finally get installed on your laptop. And how can you check that? Just go into a terminal in Windows, you can find out into the run, just write out command and it will show you the command prompt. In that you can write just Node.js minus minus version and you can find out whether your Node.js is properly installed or not. Okay, so now let's get back to a terminal. This is the installation process for how we can install in both the Ubuntu and the Windows. Now the main thing is that how, let's try to write some code of lines how the Node.js work actually. Okay, as in every language we used to learn the Hello World program. So let's get started with the basic one only. So what we will do, as I have already created the desktop, that folder, I will just navigate to that folder. You can create, what you have to do, I am going to just do cd desktop, as I have already created the folder practice one. Okay, and if you want to create a new folder, you have to just write mkdir. Okay, and after that your folder name. Okay, as I have already created that, so I will just navigate to that folder. I will write cd practice. Okay, now you can use any text editor, whatever you want to use, there is no limitation. Either you can use Atom, either you can use Visual Studio, or you can use Sublime. This is your choice completely. Right now I am having my Sublime folder, so let me open that. Okay, I will navigate to that folder. Now what you have to do, just create a file. Let me create that. You can create with the help of the terminal, or you can directly click on that file button and you can manually create that. Okay, let me create with the commands. What you have to give the command is touch app.js. This would be the main file which we are going to work upon. Okay, so as you can see that it is created. Let me open that. Now what you have to write, just let me start with a simple one, console.log and hello world. And after that I will put a semicolon and save that file. Okay, so now how we are going to run it? The simplest command that we are going to provide it to run our app.js file is, you have to just write node and app.js. Okay, let's wait for a minute. Okay, as you can see that the output is hello world. So in this way we are going to proceed, as this would be our main file in which we are going to work upon everything later on, all the database, all the other node mailer packages, or we can say that all other different type of the packages, or we can say that anything that we are going to work upon, the npm packages would be done through app.js file. This name does not specify that you have to use this only. You can use any name, but most of the time we see that it's like server.js, app.js, so it is easy to remember that this is our main file. Okay, thanks for watching this video. Stay tuned and don't forget to like, share and subscribe, and also you can press the bell icon, and you can also follow us on all our pages, and the link to the pages is given in the description below. Thank you.